New fallout after Senate Dems deployed the so-called nuclear option, voting to strip Republicans of the power to block many presidential nominees. The new rule requires a simple majority of 51 votes now instead of 60 to end debate and bring most nominations to a full floor vote. Stephen Dynan is a columnist for the Washington Times, and he's my guest today. Good to see you, Stephen.
Good to be with you.
All right. So many people were arguing that this could have happened back when the Republicans were in charge, but now we've seen the Democrats actually go through with it. Were you as stunned as so many others that they would actually take it to that measure, take it to the nth degree?
Absolutely. In particular, the timing and, as you said, the fact that they actually did it. They'd had a number of opportunities at the beginning of this year when they took control for the 113th Congress in the Senate, and then back in, I guess, July or so of this year, they had warned that they were trying this. Both times, they headed it off through these gentlemen agreements, and that's been the tradition in the Senate. You get close to this, and then you back away.
Right.
This time, this sort of came from out of nowhere. Harry Reid, the Senate Majority Leader, had set this up with a couple of key votes on some judicial nominees.
Yeah, but
so
Stephen,
we knew that he was laying.
Or did it come out of nowhere? Because could this have been an orchestrated strategy? Some people are saying for distraction from Obamacare. Others are saying so that the president could get something done in his second term. Because is it a tacit admission that his agenda is not going to go anywhere? So at least he can appeal to his political base and get some of these federal judgeships and nominations in place.
Both of those. It's absolutely both of those. Now, I guess I would say two things. The setup was always there. Harry Reid put these judicial nominations through over the last month in order to set this up. But the exact timing of it, the fact that it happened yesterday, was a bit of a surprise. In fact, it was very much a surprise. You know, in the previous ones, we'd seen weeks of debate on the floor. Mitch McConnell and Harry Reid sparred back and forth for weeks on the floor about whether to do this.
Yep.
This time, nobody had an idea until we came in yesterday, and there they went ahead with it.
Well,
real quickly,
this works for both political parties. So if the Republicans now become the majority in 2014 or 2016, what kind of revenge are we going to see?
You know, they aren't talking about that, but what she said is exactly right. Democrats lit a fuse, but it's really up to Republicans to decide how big that explosion goes. And as you said, they have the ability, if they want to do this for Supreme Court nominees, which are not covered under the deal yesterday, they can do that. If they want to do it for legislation, if they want to pick and choose, it's up to Republicans how angry they want to be. There's a possibility they just say, let's stick where we are, but I think you're going to see some retaliation. They have to do it.
Well, Mitch McConnell said, if you like the Senate rules, you can't keep them. Stephen Dynan, have a great weekend.
My pleasure.
And we want to hear from you. Why do you think the White House is pushing back the Obamacare enrollment dates now? Are they worried about the 2014 midterm elections? Go to my Facebook page, facebook.com/GretchenCarlson. You can weigh in there. We will read some of your comments, as we always do, at the end of the show.